Remember when we were losing, guys, that game? We were like just passively hanging around in the mid. And Darko was soaking top. We were level 15 versus 16, maybe. We had fewer forts and less global action, and we were just like five people in the middle. I hate that kind of situation. I remember when I walked forward as Malph, I was just like, I'm gonna engage. I walked into four people. I can only do that because I have Twilight Dream and Ice Block. 14 v 15, okay. But they were almost 16. They were 15.8. That's why Malph can carry games. I'm not saying I did. I died the most. I did good and bad. So did everyone, right? But I'm just saying, if you feel impotent as Morales in first pick, I mean, not first pick. If you feel if you're a support main, you feel impotent as Morales to influence a game. If your tanks are too passive or your assassins are too aggressive, very common problems for everyone, right? Malph can engage by pretending to be dumb, and then walk forward, and you can use a combination of Ice Block and Twilight Dream in different orders to initiate a fight. Anyway, make it really good for your team, as long as your team follows you.
Let's fly.
Malph is a great first pick because he's not countered easily. Yeah, because everything that counters him is burst. Everything that has burst gets burst by Twilight Dream. And if it becomes a full sustain war on both sides, like mass warriors on each side, you can always get tranquility, and it's still really good.
Glory to the scourge.
What if my tanks are too aggressive? Oh, I'm sure that never happens.
Tremble before
right?
Me.
Yeah, but if your tanks are too aggressive, then you can just follow them in Twilight Dream and save them. Maybe. Of course, you're going to lose roughly half your games anyway, but like, just based on how the system works. But. You can still get tranquility. For example, let's say if you have... let's say you have Johanna, Varian, Thrall and the Zeebo, and they have a similar team, and then you're like, okay, you know, whoever wins this fight, they'll win it in 18 seconds, not in 3, because there's just not enough burst. Even your Twilight Dream still cannot burst kill someone. Well, let me focus on Ban first, then you can get Trank.
Victory for the Forsaken.
Lily, really? I guess we could. I was thinking of Taronda, but it would put a lot of pressure on the blow up. And it's difficult against Arthas because of Icebound Fortitude, 25 armor, and 75% Relentless. I'm also not able to take temples myself. Oh, holy shit, we're on Infernal Shrines. Holy, I thought it was Sky Temple. Taronda wouldn't be too bad because of Starfall on the shrine. I think Taronda would have been okay.
Here we go.
But I think this is better because solo frontline Diablo can be hard. Muppet and Aux 17, thanks for the subs, guys. Valera in Hero League, Elegigle. Are you sure it's Elegigle? She could be good. Merlin gets banned from time to time, Jago stream. I don't get this draft. Your last pick and your team already has damage dealing, tank, heal, and global. What's this utopia? It's called Once in a Blue Moon Hero League. Is this a Sundering game? Probably. I hope your tongue follows suit. It's not bad for Earthquake too. It makes people unable to get away from me and Greymane. Actually, it could be Earthquake. I think this is actually an Earthquake game. It could be either one. Do I need block? Arthas Valas Valera says yes. Do I need seasons? No, we have 3 damage. Do I need Rolling Thunder? Poke easily gets outdone by Mouth. Do I need Rabbit Wolves? You never get it. It's really bad. Block is the best. Well chosen. Hey, don't laugh about block for Valera, Vlado. She's really seriously good.
Greetings, friend.
When you clear the wave fast, you're taking a gamble that they will reach late here. They're gonna lose a whole wave though. Worth it. Lucia95, thanks for subbing. So we lost someone, but they lost the wave. It roughly evens out. Arthas beats Thrall in lane, so no need to try to melee him. I just accept losing some tower shots. I can hold the lane here if I want to prevent a few shots, but I don't want to get eaten by him. I've played Arthas against Thrall often enough to know that it requires no skill to beat Thrall in lane. You just E next to him, you can't really lose it. What did he take? Block. Yeah, that makes it even harder. Hey, I haven't played HOT since some time because I have been at college, but you are the pro. If you say it is good against Valera, I'll roll with it. Okay. Yeah, Valera attacks about once every 0.7 seconds, so that makes her a relatively fast auto attacker. And yet, she also attacks with a pretty decent damage, like 150, 200. So block is pretty good against her. It's particularly good against Vala and Arthas though. When Arthas swings, Frostmourne hungers.
Strategy. Your time has come.
I guess we should not sack objective to Sylvanas, but is this the second time they died when I'm top? Frozen Punisher has been set against us. Now we need to massively react to this. I'm going to go ride the lightning for self-sustain, providing backline pressure to distract them, pretending to go in and actually not. Because if I actually go in, I'm dead. I might still be dead. I'm dead. Should have been a bit more conservative. But I don't know, they died anyway. I think my choice to stay top was wrong because they have Sylvanas. When you're against certain heroes, you cannot employ the we split push while they get the shrine type of strategy. Certain heroes get too much from winning the shrine. Otherwise, it can be a valid strategy to use this. I'll list the heroes that you are not allowed to skip shrines for. One is Sylvanas. The other is Arthas level 10 with Sundergoza. And another one is Illidan, because he punishes unfavorable odds too much. He punishes unfavorable odds too much. Because Illidan in a favorite fight will chase down everyone and kill him. So I have this rule against Illy. Always group. No matter how split pushy hero you are, no matter how split pushy you build your hero, you group. And Sylvanas really should be included. And I realized it too late. So my bad. We fall behind, which is really risky against Sylph on Infernal Shrine. But hopefully we will not pay the ultimate price in 200 ranked points loss. They just got this, so that means they're below me. That's risky. Oh shit, I thought it was gonna flip, but he got stunned by Valera. Well done. I was aiming the root for the flip. The root sandstorm for the flip. Is he gonna slow me down now? No, Arthur's roaming mid. Careful. What else did he take? Oh yes, the quest for E. Do you think that Abba needs some buffs? No, he's in a good spot. I guess we should go hard. I guess we showed up late as well. Do we have the late? I don't know. Wailing, Twilight Dream, Smoke Bomb, Reign of Vengeance, and he's still thinking about it, but it's definitely going to be Army of the Dead.
Your time has come.
Yeah, we might lose keep. Maybe we should get a tower. Yeah, we will probably lose keep. We should have soaked, yeah. One more wave, it's needed. Guess we're... Oh my god. It's actually kind of good that she isn't here. But we do lose the keep. Sylvanas, Elegiggle. 100% fort disable. A fun mechanic. Really, I wish they would take my suggestion already. 90% structural disable. 90, not 100. That is too black and white. Mostly black arrow. I think we probably... Do we get Sundering? Or Earthquake? You can give Sylvanas more interesting fighting kit as soon as you remove 100% disable black arrow. 90% means it will attack once every 10 times it would normally. So it's just very slow attack. You still get some value out of your fort, but not no value. Your 13 already is too late. They know we're bruising for a fight. We're showing mid. Let's at least get 11. They're definitely gonna come here. You know that they are. Like, they're not gonna ignore Fallen Shaman on a fort at this play, at this point when they're so ahead. So to actually push with it now, especially when Oppo is missing, would be very risky. Once they saw I left, the rest of them went here. I see Arthas was already waiting in the bushes. Once they left, the rest went here. Arthas stayed a bit to anchor. I think that's what happened. Today. I'll get Earthquake, I think. We should probably get the towers.
And claim the shrine. Show its guardians
Got someone.
Our core is that under attack.
Which one? Which one? Which one? Why focus Arthas? That's a great question. But if I moved past him, I think it will take too long to get to the rest. I would have loved to go for the others, but I was fully aware that it's not ideal to be on Arthas, but he placed himself directly in front of me, so it would take a long time to get to the rest, and once I would get there, there'd be no way back either. Wait. I don't know what they're talking about. Yeah, I think the worst thing is putting some damage on Arthas. I don't know, there's some kind of passive-aggressive exchange going on, and I'm not sure what it's all about. I mean, the whole position was quite tough, I agree. I think that's kind of what the problem was. Okay, that was good. Oh shit.
Enemy is beginning to falter. The enemy is attacking our core.
Gotta go.
The enemy's
see you later.
Punisher has been vanquished.
We did something.
At last. Warriors, attack their fort.
I guess we just grab a camp, don't tilt. Just keep playing solid and hope they throw. You can always rely on people throwing. You can at least rely on it, whether or not it happens. Let's go. Tempest Fury.
Your spirit is strong. Killing double kill, triple kill. Destroy the
core. I'll see you soon, Liam.
At last.
I don't want to lose the final keep to freaking impalers.
Warriors, attack their fort!
Warriors, attack their fort!
Lily 20 will carry us if we ever get there. Our push power doesn't seem as good as theirs. We kill 4, but we can't get a fountain. But let's just focus on the objective. We've got the lanes that are difficult pushed. We've got the initiative on the shrine, and we're equal level. What a state. We just need like 6 more fights like that. Does Tempest Fury proc Giant Killer? Yep. They could just like 5 mana or Bot's Keep or something. Wailing Mist, nice. I recommend a Gust. We have Gust. Okay. No, no, no. No, 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 no. Just. Okay. It's a Thrall thing. He tends to shout things that are meant to be said. Like, Fall used Fly to do a barrel roll forward when he could have just used it to wave clear. Oh. Not like I've seen his marksman either, so I'll just go back to the fight. Just for motivation. Luktar. Careful, Fall. Lily level 20 will carry us if we ever get there. Look at those serpents, man. Whew! Grubby, do you still play RuneScape? Never did. I'm also not still using Grindr. Never did. This is the most obvious place for us to get. But they are showing in lane, so it's okay. Actually, it was a real toss-up between Earthen Shields and Bolt. But I need the mobility to get around Arthas if I must. They could be going for a Fallen Shaman. Do we have Kung Fu Hustle? Nice! Very good! Now we kind of need to break this open. Communications breakdown! They're probably on our Fallen. Yeah, I would say they are. We can clear it easy though. We clear the mid, then we clear the Fallen, and then they did never clear up the Impalers yet. Oh, they actually went to clear safely. I guess they weren't that sure that they're gonna get level 20 yet on time. So this gives us a good deep push in all the relevant lanes. Right as the objective comes up. I feel like we should do one more wave as well. Like, I'm talking about one more in the deep here. This will help push a bit what I did, even though it made my teammates nervous and we're a little bit late to position. I guess that's true. I'm gonna go flank. So, I don't know what happened with me and Arthas, but that was not a good story. It's a 3-for-2 in our disadvantage. I don't know what happened. I know I did something really good at the start of the fight. Ah! Okay. Alright. And Diablo's back. I did something really good on Sylvanas. But then, I blinked into Arthas, thinking that we could 5v1 him, but that was wrong. And at the same time, I think Valyra killed somebody, but I did not see it. So I think, yeah, bolting into Arthas was the thing I should not be doing. So the Sylvanas kill is great, but after that, I think I should have just tried to run away until I take too much focus fire and save Bolt. Nonetheless, because of Diablo's trait,
We have summoned an arcane punisher from
because of the Albus traits, we were able to turn around, and because of Kung Fu Hustle, Six City. Alright, let's go, let's go. They just revived Valera, so we're good. There's no catapult build up mid, and they're only level 21 catapults. So mid will be able to resist for quite some time, at least a minute, without having to clear. And top actually got pushed previously, so... Man, what a comeback so far. Oh, we need to get the keep. Okay, Arthas. I hit you. Thassa died too, though. That was a really cool Gust play. Really cool. Did not really need to bolt there, but okay.
Awesome!
Yeah, we do need to clear. Like I said, we can resist for about a minute.
Let's go take a merc camp.
And that's it. Our core is just about had it. It's sick to the core. That was an unintended pun. Man, I'm so funny sometimes. Sick to the core of these catapults in the mother trucking lane. It was like 45 seconds. Well, it would have lasted for another 15 and then the core would have died.
Take this camp and bolster our ranks.
This hero must.
I have so little mana, but I feel like I don't really have that much time to go mess around. I'm not sure this is a good idea. We don't need to force.
Take this camp and bolster our
we should have grabbed that camp ages ago. Like, this is not a time to suddenly get desperate. When basically, whatever we've been doing has been working. They're looking to 5-man this. I should have Hearthstone a while ago, you see. It's my heart. It's the Hearthstone cancel that really hurt. I could have been here earlier, but it's not like they were gonna push anyway, especially since they saw me Hearthstoning as well. But still, we have to be careful here. And here, and here. Okay, they're on the shrine. Arthas is on the bot left. I'm gonna flank again. Nice, roots down. Valera's here. We killed one, we lost one, and we lost Diablo, but he's back. And we're ahead in skellies. Run! No! Help! Yes! And the catapult core! The catapults on the core! Get him! Yes!
You are more fearless than
Oh my god, this game! I think what I did was fine. I went for Sylph, I nearly got her, and I pulled away Vala and Sylph, and I didn't die. This game, though, this is a big, big build up here. We need to deal with this first. This is actual fortification damage. This is like potential shield core damage. This one. Just get the souls and go. Okay. They still have three dead. One more wave. One more wave. Bomb. Okay. I need to go now. Hey, Ghost! No, it's fine. My god, Valera. Alright, it's down. They've only got three keeps left. It's all good. Does he have Epic Mount? No, oh no, of course he has Wind Tunnel. Epic Mount would be kind of nice to, you know, deep push all the waves, but I guess Wind Tunnel is pretty snazzy as well. Look at our levels from what we've gotten from all the wave pushes. Delete what? Now is not the time to self-castigate or mutilate. That's for after the game. Or maybe not at all, it's just a game. It's okay, I'm cool. Hey, have a great whatever day too, Haku, thank you. Keep pressure again or what? Okay, we de-pushed again. Lanes still look fine. Always do spare a quick look at the lanes. Very nice play by Falstad here, doing the Mighty Gust, pushing them into an Earthquake. Diablo did really well as well. I think we're doing it, but you're welcome. People are always prone to let their ego take over. Core.
Destroy their core.
The angel's smile, double kill. The core! Yeah! We won, lol.
Look, Dar!
Diamond 2. What a game. One keep down at 7 minutes. Second keep down, 17. We win in 27. Oh, Diamond 1. Yeah. Nice. 444 points. Levels 25-23. Game time 29-59.
I thank you.
For Infernal Shrines map. Any pro tips for rotating into the shrine objectives and team fights?
Yeah, if they have a very snowballing victorious team, always 5-man the shrine. Like Sylvanas and Illidan must be stopped by all 5. If they have a split soak team, it's different. Are you having a bit of a giggle? Are you having a bit of a giggle? 163,000 heal, not bad, you know. Mass vortex hindering wins. 2-for-1 kung fu hustle. God. I'm sorry. We do have a camp pushing, so I guess some delay is good. And they didn't pay entirely, so.
Thank you, my friend.
Not bad. Oh, very nice find. Very nice find. And Wrath of the Berserker has run out.
Let's go.
Kill them all. Kill them all. Oh. Ah, oh, I didn't get the last hit with blind. What a pity.
Why not?